have seen your videos, and for the last 3-4 days, all she's been talking about is your abs.
Okay.
And she's dying at one point today to get a picture taken with your abs.
Put your hand right here.
Go ahead, go on, do it, do it, do it!
Thank you.
Look at this. Yes, yeah. Official touch, and she's going back.
Oh. And that's there, and right there. Right here.
That's going on YouTube.
Look at her. Look at her. Look at her. You made her. You made her life.
You see what I got to work with here. Yeah. You know. I mean, that was like.
What? Yeah, look at like, baby. Yay! Yeah.
Let me just took his shirt off. Put your shirt back on.
That's my work next to now. You understand?
It's a full moon tonight.
Again, we've got Lloyd hanging out with us. You know, with the music business, back up off his abs now, Andy.
All right, I'm done.
When it comes to the music business and the way things are now, you know, you've got people that are making careers out. I mean, obviously they have talent, but they're making careers off of having beef with somebody else.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like, you know, you had the 50 Kanye thing just recently. Yeah. You had the 50 thing in Ja Rule.
That's Fat Joe.
Yeah, for you. Yeah, and Papoose and his whole crew. But for you, has there ever been, you know, like a beef with anybody? I mean, I know that everybody's got problems with everybody.
Right.
At one point or another. And, like, you know, off the air, myself and Andy, we've had arguments off the air.
Yeah.
I've had arguments with management and stuff like that. But is there any...
Nah, CJ, man, I like to stray away from that kind of stuff.
And that's all, yeah.
My music is more positive, and it's more about, like, bringing people together to have a good time together. Mm-hmm. You know, where I'm from in the South, we don't like to beef with each other. You might listen to the song, the radio, and you hear a song with Ludacris, GVTI, and Lloyd, all on the same
all
song.
All on the same track.
Then we go to a show, you might see us all on the same stage, you know, having everybody having a good time together, and it's like a unity, and that's what I cherish more than anything.
Yeah, because I mean, for me, it's like, you know, the whole 50 Ja Rule thing from way back, I mean, that really set, it's like, people look at a formula, and they say, ooh, that formula worked, and let's try to do it. Let's try to, you know, concoct it. Like the 50 and Kanye thing. I thought 50 was supposed to retire. He didn't retire. You know what I mean? It's just that, for me, it's like, why bother? And that's why I think I appreciate your music so much, is because I don't get that vibe at all.
I like to let my music speak for me.
And that's awesome, and we appreciate that.
I think for all you inspiring artists, as long as you make good music that people can relate to and is genuine, then everything else will work out. You know?
All right. 8:44, we're going to take a quick break. We'll come back. What's the next track we're going to play?
Oh, man, I brought a few special treats for you guys.
Yeah, this is a song. We haven't heard this one yet, right?
Well, yeah, these are all off of my new album, Lessons in Love, which doesn't even come out until July.
Okay.
But I just couldn't help myself because I'm just feeling it over here.
Love it.
And I want you guys to feel it this morning. What I'm going to play next is exclusive Lloyd and Lil Weezy.
Oh, all right. We'll get to it next here inside the Playhouse. Don't move. 8:47, it is the Playhouse forecast real quick. What do we got?
Partly sunny today, maybe a shower, high 53. Clear tonight, low 32, and it's 42 right now in Newburgh.
All right, still hanging out with us. We got Lloyd in studio, and you've brought some...
If you're listening out there, this is by far the funnest place in the world.
It's 96 Rock.
There we go,
okay,
baby.
DJ Rocks.
Thank you very much.
Rocks.
See?
And what was my nickname? You gave me my nickname. It was Rock Solid.
See, that's the title of a new song.
That's my next tattoo.
All right, so we're going to play another track. Now, this track is actually off your new CD, which isn't even coming out till the summer, right?
Yeah, it's called Lessons in Love, and I call it Lessons in Love is because I'm taking you guys to school to re-educate people on what it means to be passionate.
Awesome.
We're going to restore the love and love making music. This is my first shot at producing, guys.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I co-produced this with my friend Big Reese, who I recorded you in his basement with Lil Weezy.
Really?
It's amazing how they do this stuff.
Our first time making beats is really cool, and I called my tag team partner Wayne. It's called Girls Around the World, and it's about going a lot of places, seeing a lot of pretty faces, but never quite seeing one like Ann. So. Think like a 1988 house party. If I could shoot a video for this song, it would be a house party parody with me and Chris Brown.
Yeah.
It would be really fun.
All right, good stuff.
You heard it here first.
All right, here we go. Oh, with the beat.
88.
New Lord.
Gotta make you understand, girl.
Ain't no stylist, girls are wearing. In your pocket, never throwing. All my time is for
Actually, sick. Really, the whole
okay, I roll up.
I emailed
him. This is the whole up. It's young money, man. Shot a man with smile, but ain't a damn thing funny. I'm so new with the money, so baby, if I move, then I move with the money. Which is my favorite dish, but if I taste you, that'll probably sweat. And then we would probably.
I forgot the words again.
You heard it here first inside the Playhouse. That was brand new Lloyd featuring Lil Wayne.
Brand
yo,
new.
Unbelievable.
Heard it here first.
Yo, let me tell you, that is that beat and that vibe bringing you back. You hit the nail on the head when you said back in the day, house party, back in the late 80s for me.
CJ was breaking it down.
Yo!
No, I was everybody's just like, go CJ! Go CJ!
In my parachute pants. Toad Adidas.
Your
denim
jacket?
Yeah.
Your mullet, though.
CJ used to have a mullet?
We used to have a mullet. First of all, Annie wears a nice headgear when she was young. Again, we do have Lloyd hanging out with us, and again, we really appreciate you coming by.
Thanks for having me.
When it comes to your new stuff, I know you got a new CD coming out this summer. Mm-hmm. That track, obviously, which we just heard, is going to be out hopefully this summer, because that just got that summer vibe.
But
when it comes to the internet, we were talking off the air about the internet and how it affects you as an artist. Now, you got a lot of people that get their hands on something, release it on the internet, and I guess, how do you feel about that?
Finding the positive, that's always the key. Mm-hmm. You know, whereas the internet is an avenue where a lot of songs are leaked and a lot of songs are illegally downloaded, mm-hmm. I have it like this rapper's mentality, where rappers will put out mixtapes mm-hmm. to the streets, and they'll just provide, you know, people with tons and tons and tons of music so that when the album comes out, then people already know, okay, this guy's good,
yeah.
And his album's going to be just as good. Mm-hmm. So, you know, in an industry where there's a lot of ringtones, ringtone artists, you know, mm-hmm. where you buy the album, you spend 13 of your hard-earned dollars on just two or three songs, mm-hmm. and you kind of get fed up, and you say, well, I'm going to just go and get the song for 99 cents now.
Yep.
You know, and I'm going to preview it for about 30 seconds just to make sure I like it,
yep.
you know? So you just got to really come with it. And you just have to try to use everything to your advantage.
Yeah, it's amazing to me how the internet's changed the music industry.
Yeah,
it really
big time,
is.
Big
it's,
time.
You know, I mean, from, I mean, growing up in music and loving it as much as I love it, you uh-huh. know, the mixtape thing for me is I remember hearing, you know, stuff from, you know, artists like 50 and, you know, and Fat Joe and all, I mean, before they popped, you know, and that's how it worked. I mean, that's how, you know, it all came together. And nowadays, you can go, I can literally log on a website right now and probably find, you know, that track we just heard probably somewhere, right? Mm-hmm. Which is ridiculous. And for me, it's ridiculous. I want people to get, obviously, you want people to hear your music, mm-hmm. but I just want to make sure, for me, like, it would suck to do something and put as much into it as you do and not to get paid for it.
Right.
That was, I mean, you know, and I know everybody would agree with that. You don't want to work for free.
Yeah.
You know, so, I mean, hopefully you get compensated the way that you should be and people
well,
are,
Well, I
know.
Mean, no matter how successful you become, there's always a high expectation for the next time around. Mm-hmm. You know, people say, okay, he rocked us last year,
yep.
but what has he got this year, you
yep.
know? Because these other guys are coming with it, man.
And obviously, I just heard what you got coming in. Oh, my God.
Well, and hopefully you guys like they call me up, tell me what you
yeah,
think.
Yeah, and we definitely, you know, I mean, obviously, as we make our way through the show this morning, again, we can't thank you enough for coming by. And we're going to play it. We got to go back. We got to do the U track. Because for me,
it
was that track that just, I'm like, wow.
That's the Spandau Ballet remix.
Yeah, see, and for me, I'm not even going to say no. I'm just going to play it. Get that back in the Playhouse with Lloyd in studio.
Ah!
96.1 Kiss FM at 906. Good morning. It is the Playhouse.
Oh, can you say, guys, this is definitely the Playhouse.